Hey ambitious aspirants, I'm Advocate Tamanna and welcome to Anmol Mehta Super 20 IAS. So guys, आज की वीडियो में हम पढ़ने वाले हैं some important programs of agriculture department. तो थोड़ा एग्रीकल्चर इन हिमाचल प्रदेश के बारे में जान लेते हैं. एग्रीकल्चर प्लेज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल इन द इकोनॉमी ऑफ हिमाचल प्रदेश. ऑलमोस्ट 90% पीपल जो हैं वो रूरल एरियाज में रहते हैं एंड 62% पीपल वो डायरेक्टली डिपेंडेंट हैं एग्रीकल्चर के ऊपर. एग्रीकल्चर एंड अलाइड सेक्टर्स वो कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट करती है अबाउट 12.73% टू स्टेट्स GDP. दैट्स क्वाइट हाई फॉर एग्रीकल्चर. The land is cultivated on 5.42 lakh hectare and the average holding size is about 0.5 hectares. So, Himachal mein 87.95% jo farmers hain, we belong karte hain marginal and small section, jinke paas 54.18% of the land hai to be sown. 11.71% farmers jo hain, wo middle category mein aate hain. एंड 0.34% फार्मर्स ही हैं जो बिग फार्मर्स हैं. द एग्रो क्लाइमेट ऑफ द स्टेट इज वेरी गुड फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ कैश क्रॉप्स. सो लेट्स लर्न अबाउट स्टेट स्पॉन्सर्ड स्कीम्स ऑफ हिमाचल प्रदेश. सबसे पहले है क्रॉप डाइवर्सिफिकेशन प्रमोशन प्रोजेक्ट. टू प्रमोट एग्रीकल्चर डाइवर्सिफिकेशन इन हिमाचल प्रदेश, हिमाचल प्रदेश क्रॉप डाइवर्सिफिकेशन प्रमोशन प्रोजेक्ट that is worth Rs. 321 crore has been implemented with the help of Japan International Cooperation Agency. Under this, promotion of vegetable production and crop diversification through irrigation facilities, road access to the farm, providing technical information for vegetable production and marketing by forming group of farmers, training the agriculture officers working in the project area, etc. This project is run by Himachal Pradesh Agriculture Development Society, which has a governing body headed by Agriculture Minister and Executive Committee ko head karte hain, jo secretary hain agriculture ke. Ye jo project hai, ye implement kiya gaya hai in 5 districts of the state. Kaun kaun se hain wo? Bilaspur, Hamirpur, Mandi, Kangra and Una in planned manner by 7 years. Under this project, 210 minor irrigation schemes, 147 linked roads, 37 collection centers are being built and special importance has been given to vegetable production. The next is Chief Minister's Nutan Poly House project. So state government ne proposed kiya tha Chief Minister Nutan Poly House project that is worth Rs. 150 crore from the year 2019 to 2020, under which 5,000 poly houses will be built. This project will be implemented in 2 phases. The duration of first phase will be for 3 years, 2020 to 21 and 22 to 23, and an investment of Rs. 78.57 crores will be made on it. Expenses will be made. In the first phase, 2522 poly houses will be built. Under this scheme, 85% subsidy is available to the farmers for applying micro irrigation in the poly house and inside it. Ye jo project hai, approved kiya gaya hai by NABARD for financial assistance in March 2020. This year, Rs. 20 crore will be spent on this project and 500 poly houses will be built. Next is Chief Minister Greenhouse Renewal Scheme. तो स्टेट गवर्नमेंट ने स्टार्ट किया है मुख्यमंत्री ग्रीन हाउस रिन्यूअल स्कीम फ्रॉम द ईयर 2017 टू 18 टू रिप्लेस द पॉली शीट अंडर द पॉली हाउस. अंडर दिस स्कीम जो 70% ग्रांट है वो दी जाती है बाय द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट टू रिप्लेस द पॉली शीट आफ्टर 5 इयर्स और इफ इट इज डैमेज्ड बाय नेचुरल कैलमिटी. अ प्रोविजन ऑफ Rs. 1 करोड़ हैज बीन मेड ऑन दिस स्कीम for the year 2020 to 2021. Next, efficient irrigation scheme through micro irrigation. इस स्कीम का मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव है टू प्रोवाइड एफिशियंट एंड अश्योर्ड इरीगेशन फैसिलिटी to the farming community in the state by proper use of water. Micro irrigation like sprinkler, drip is being encouraged in the state, and through this project, 8500 hectare area will be bought under drip sprinkler irrigation system. So, इस स्कीम के अंडर जो 80% सब्सिडी है is given on the installation of micro irrigation system. A provision of rupees 30 crore has been made for this scheme this year. Next is Chief Minister Farmer and Farmer Mazdoor Jeevan Suraksha Yojana. ये जो स्कीम है ये स्टार्ट की गई है बाय द गवर्नमेंट टू प्रोवाइड असिस्टेंस टू फार्मर्स एंड एग्रीकल्चर लेबरर्स ऑल्सो नोन एज मजदूर इन द केस दे गेट इंजर्ड और डाई ड्यूरिंग द यूज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर मशीनरी इन दिस असिस्टेंट ऑफ रुपीज 3 lakh विल बी प्रोवाइडेड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ असिस्टेंस इन द केस ऑफ डेथ रुपीज 1 lakh इन द केस ऑफ परमानेंट डिसेबिलिटी and 10,000 to 40,000 as assistance to the affected in case of partial or permanent disability. 40 lakh on this scheme for this year provision has been made. Next is Chief Minister's Farm Protection Scheme. So, क्या होता है? बहुत सारे जो crops हैं वो damage हो जाते हैं by monkeys or wild animals. To protect this, the state government has started the Chief Minister's Hate protection scheme. Under this scheme, there is a provision of 80% grant to the farmers for setting up solar-powered fencing at individual level and 85% for group-based fencing. So, ये जो fence है, it's being transmitted by solar power. So, electric current है, वो इस fence में दौड़ता है to help to keep stray animals, wild animals, and monkeys away. In the view of the demand and suggestion of the farmers. 50% सब्सिडी है वो दी जा रही है फॉर इंस्टॉलिंग बार्ब वायर्स और चेन लिंक फेंस 70% सब्सिडी है वो दी जा रही है फॉर इरेक्टिंग कॉम्पोजिट फेंसिंग एंड अ प्रोविजन ऑफ 40 करोड़ हैज बीन मेड फॉर दिस स्कीम दिस ईयर बेस्ट फॉर्डर प्रोडक्शन स्कीम तो स्टेट में प्रोडक्शन फॉर्डर की इंक्रीज करने के लिए फॉर्डर प्रोडक्शन स्कीम इसमें क्या है क्वालिटी सीड्स ऑफ फॉर्डर ग्रास Cuttings and seedlings of improved fodder varieties are being provided to the farmers at subsidized rates. The Department of Agriculture is giving up to 50% subsidy to all farmers on the seeds of chari, bajra, oats, barseem, buttergrass and fodder maize. The fodder cutting machine hoti hai, it is an important tool for farmers. The government is providing 50% subsidy on fodder cutting machines to CST and BPL farmers. The state government is also encouraging farmers to take up the cultivation of azolla grass. Iske liye government is giving 50% subsidy to the farmers for making pits. So under this scheme, rupees 5.60 crore will be spent this year. Next is construction of lift irrigation scheme and borewell scheme. So in those areas of the state, जहाँ पे जो surface water sources हैं, that are available for irrigation in deeper places than agriculture holdings, individual level small medium lift irrigation schemes are made, and where surface water sources are not available for irrigation, and where underground water is possible, Department of Agriculture encourages farmers to set up individual bore wells for agriculture irrigation. So आपको bore well तो पता होगा क्या है? Any person or group of farmers who construct lift irrigation scheme and establish bore well, then they will be given 50% subsidy. Water storage tanks, sprinklers, and water pipes are also being made available under this scheme. So, this scheme ke under a provision of 10 crore has been made. Next is agriculture marketing. Small vegetable collection centers and market yards are being built at different places for the convenience of marketing to reach every farmer's doorstep. A total of 10 mandis and 50 sub-mandis are functioning in the state. Ye jo present government hai, it's trying to promote marketing through mandis and cold stores. 10 crore mandis this year will be spent. And so far, 19 mandis are functioning under e-portal in the state, and 10 mandis are being connected through this portal. Next is Jal Se Krishi Ko Bal Yojana. So, is scheme ke under, check dams and ponds wo banaye jayenge at suitable places in the state. जिससे farmers वो use कर सकते हैं water collected in them for irrigation by making individual small lift irrigation schemes or flow irrigation schemes जो भी required होगा. तो इस scheme के under rupees 250 crore will be spent for 5 years and rupees 25 crore will be spent this year only. Under this scheme, 100% expenditure for the implementation of community small water harvesting schemes वो सब government pay करेगी. Next is flow irrigation scheme. इस scheme के under work is done to renew the sources of dust in the state and strengthen the dust in community areas. इस scheme के under 100% expenditure for all community works will be borne by the government. Under the scheme, there is a provision कि 50% assistance दी जाएगी on construction of bore wells and shallow wells at individual level. 150 crore will be spent under this scheme for 5 years and this year 15 crore will be spent. Next is Krishi Kosh. Farmer producer organizations are the bodies of primary producers like farmers, gardeners, milk producers, fishermen, etc. Farmers and gardeners are often unsuccessful in mobilizing resources. Unko kya kya chahiye hota hai? Infrastructure like grading and packaging machines, transportation, warehousing, godowns, pack houses and other inputs, sowing se leke harvest and post harvest tak, which require a very long term capital. So isi ko dimag mein rakhte hue, to state government ne ek provision banayi hai of setting up a Krishi Kosh of rupees 20 crore this year, jiske dwara farmers producers organizations will be provided seed money, subsidy on bank loans and credit guarantee cover. तो इसमें सब कुछ ही कवर हो गया. पहले सीड मनी भी दी जा रही है, उसके बाद सब्सिडी भी एंड देन क्रेडिट गारंटी कवर भी. फॉर दिस डिटेल गाइडलाइंस आर बीइंग प्रिपेयर्ड बाय द गवर्नमेंट. तो बाय 2022 दैट इज नेक्स्ट ईयर 75,000 टू 90,000 फार्मर्स आर लाइकली टू गेट द बेनिफिट ऑफ कृषि कोष. नेक्स्ट इज कृषि से संपन्नता योजना. सो एक न्यू वैरायटी ऑफ एसाफोटिडा हैज बीन आइडेंटिफाइड बाय द इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ हिमालयन बायोटेक्नोलॉजी पालमपुर, which can be grown in high altitude areas of Chamba, Lahaul Spiti and Kinnaur districts. ये काफी high altitude पे हैं और यहाँ पे ये grow करना quite difficult है. Similarly, favorable climate and environment have been found in some areas for the cultivation of saffron. तो promote करने के लिए इन दोनों को the state government has proposed कृषि संपन्नता योजना for this year. Under this, the MOU with the text has been already signed. So under this scheme, introduction of asafoetida and saffron cultivation and demonstration of the both in the fields of progressive farmers is included. Next is agriculture produce protection scheme, anti-hail nets 2020-21. So under this scheme, to protect the crops from hailstorm, 80% grant hai wo di jayegi to the farmers on the purchase of anti-hail nets by the state government. Anti-hail nets jo hain wo diye jayenge to all vegetable growing farmers of the state taki wo apni crop ko bacha sake from natural calamities, so that the crops can be saved from hailstorm, stray animals and monkeys also, and to buy anti-hail nets to all farmers of the state. Iske liye financial provision of 10 crore has been made by the government and a grant will be made available to the eligible farmers at the rate of 28 per square meter, in which eligible farmers can take benefits under this scheme for maximum 5000 square meters. Next is cultivation of tea and coffee. So tea and coffee ye bahut important drinks hain and bahut popular drinks bhi hain all over the world. So tea cultivation in the state is being done in Dholadhar Botanical Garden of District Kangra since the year 1849. There are 2,315 hectares of land under tea cultivation in the state. So, tea cultivation ke liye तो कुछ स्कीम जो इम्प्लीमेंट की गई हैं फॉर द फार्मर्स बाय टेक्निकल ऑफिसर्स कौन कौन सी हैं? डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ इम्प्रूव्ड वैरायटी ऑफ प्लांट्स टू द फार्मर्स, प्लानिंग ऑफ डिस्प्ले प्लॉट्स एंड एग्जिबिट टू. नेक्स्ट इज मल्टीप्लीकेशन एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ गुड क्वालिटी सीड्स. तो एग्रीकल्चर डिपार्टमेंट के पास उनके अपने 36 मल्टीप्लीकेशन फार्म्स हैं वेयर सीड्स आर प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर राबी एंड खारिफ क्रॉप्स. तो अबाउट 3500 टू 4000 क्विंटल्स ऑफ सीड्स ऑफ सीरियल्स, पल्सेस एंड वेजिटेबल्स वो प्रोड्यूस की जाते हैं एनुअली इन दीज सीड फार्म्स. तो इसके अलावा 90,000 क्विंटल्स ऑफ सर्टिफाइड सीड्स ऑफ वेरियस क्रॉप्स आर डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड बाय द डिपार्टमेंट टू द फार्मर्स ऑफ द स्टेट. नेक्स्ट वन इज प्लांट प्रोटेक्शन. तो इस प्रोग्राम के अंडर डिपार्टमेंट कीप्स अ कॉन्स्टेंट विजिल ऑन द स्टेट ऑफ डिसीजेज एंड पेस्ट आउटब्रेक्स इन द क्रॉप्स. रीजनल इंसेक्टिसाइड टेस्टिंग लैब हैज बीन एस्टेब्लिश्ड इन शिमला विच टेस्ट 300 टू 400 सैंपल्स पर ईयर एज पर इट्स कैपेसिटी. तो इसके अलावा एक बायो कंट्रोल लैब भी है एंड एक बायोलॉजिकल इंसेक्टिसाइड लैब वो भी है इन पालमपुर for the purposes of controlling pests by biological methods. जहाँ पे conservation pest status, growth, rearing and testing for bioagent and extension workers and farmers are being given and biocontroller agents are created. The next is quality control. So under this scheme, the implementation of quality control under various acts on seeds, fertilizers and pesticides is ensured. For this, quality control officers has been notified in the state. So, three fertilizer labs hain that are functioning by the department at Hamidpur, Sundarnagar and Shimla. Three seed testing labs at Solan, Palampur and Mandi. And insecticide labs at Shimla. These are already established and running hain. In these, 2000 samples of fertilizers, 300 samples of insecticides and 700 samples of seeds are being analyzed every year. तो quality check state है वो काफी अच्छी तरह करता है through these labs. So I hope you guys like the video. If you like the video, give us a thumbs up, share it with your friends, comment if you have any doubts, subscribe to our channel and turn on the bell icon. Thank you so much for watching and happy learning.